Good morning to all the students of political science back here. I am back with the sixth part of this chapter, and I shall try to finish this chapter in this particular part, as just two topics are left and these are two small topics. And here the name of your topic is New International Economic Order. In short, we call it NEO. It was established around 1970s. So the question is, what was this particular organization, New International Economic Order? Before I tell you this, I would like to tell you, as I told you in the last part, there were bipolar, that is run by US, other was run by USSR. But some countries, newly decolonized countries from the British rule, got the third option, and it was, name was NAM, Non-Alignment Movement. These were the countries which did not wanted to be a part of any of these two alliances anyhow, because their major focus was on their economic development just after their freedom from the British rule or after decolonization. So here, the member of the New International Economic Order, this was the head which was seeing the economic development of all the non-aligned countries. So all the countries which got the freedom from, or they were decolonized, were running under this policy for their economic order. Non-aligned countries raised the challenge was to more developed economy. So of all the countries which were under non-aligned countries, their major focus was for their economic development, which was taken under New International Economic Order. The majority of NAM countries were categorized as least developed countries. Most of the countries of non-alignment group were least developed countries. They were the countries which did not have the basic amenities, basic facilities in their countries, and there was main focus at just after decolonization was to get the economic development. These were the least developed countries, which were non-aligned countries. So to improve their condition and to give them some economic development, trade, industries, technology, and other economic development activities were started by New International Economic Order to raise the level of these underdeveloped countries to developing nations. So trade, industries, and technology, and other economic activities were taken up by them. But this particular organization was working well around 1970s, but slowly and gradually its effect faded away, as unfortunately NEO due to poor cooperation from the developed nations could not do much, as the developed nations which were the part of US and USSR did not support the countries of NAM for their economic development, and slowly and gradually the effect of New Economic International Order faded away. So this was the purpose of New Economic Order. And further, the next topic which I will be taking is India and the Cold War. So this is the topic now, India and the Cold War. So in this topic, we will be talking about what was the relation or the role of India during the Cold War. So this was a period in 1945, as I told you, till 1991. So what was the role of India? So this topic is totally in relevance to India, that what was the role of India in during Cold War. So India responded to this particular period of Cold War in two folds. There were two folds, or the two points through which India took or responded to Cold War. First was, India stayed away from alliances. Which were these two alliances? Now you very well know US and USSR. So US was the Western Alliance and USSR was the Eastern Alliance. So India was not a part of any of these two alliances. It followed a separate path, which name was NAM, Non-Alignment Movement. So India stayed away from any two alliances, as India just got the freedom and India wanted it economic development and other sectors to grow as fast as possible. So it did not wanted to be involved in any of these two alliances. Next fold was, India raised voice against newly decolonized countries becoming part of either of the alliances. Here India, we can see that India started taking part or decisions in the international affairs. Here India raised its voice against the countries from Asia, Africa, and Latin America. Now these countries started, some of the countries wanted to join any of these two alliances, US and USSR. But here India tried and stopped these newly decolonized countries from joining any of these alliances, as India wanted them to understand the meaning of freedom and sovereignty, and India wanted them to focus on their economic development, either than involving in any of these two alliances. So two faults were India itself was maintaining distance or aloofness from the, any of the two superpowers, and along with it, it was also stopping other newly decolonized countries from becoming a part of these two alliances. So India wanted these newly decolonized countries to become the member of NAM here. So now, moving on further to the next point, after India was supporting the newly decolonized countries to be the member of NAM and not to be a part of any of the two alliances, as a major focus was to gain the economic development just after freedom. So here next point is, Nehru reminded the world that NAM was not a policy of neutrality. Here in the last part, I have already discussed these two words, isolation and neutrality. As many of the political scholars or political thinkers during that particular period said that NAM followed neutrality and isolation, that is staying away from war or staying away from world affairs or world events. But here Nehru reminded the world that the purpose of India was not neutrality or isolation. Although India took Nehru played an important role in the war between North and South Korea. As I told you, when I was telling you about the arenas of the Cold War, in Korea, war was between North and South Korea, in which Nehru, Jawaharlal Nehru, who was the one of the founding member of the NAM, played a very important role in solving out the conflict and confrontation between these two places. So we can say that India, along with other members of NAM, always worked to reduce the tension and conflicts among the two alliances at various period of time. So Nehru proved here that NAM was not associated with neutrality and isolation, as Nehru played an important role in resolving the things or mediating the things between North and South Korea. In many other events, other members of the NAM also have done these things. So now the next was allowed to take. Here, as a member of NAM, India or the other members of NAM was allowed to take international decision and could balance one superpower against other. So here India was able to take its international decisions. If India was not a part of NAM and India would have been a part of US or would have joined the alliance of US or USSR, it would have not been able to take its international decisions for its own economic or other developments in the other sectors. But as a member of NAM, India was free to take its own decisions. So we can say the advantage of being a member of NAM was that India was able to take international decisions and could balance one superpower against the other means, like in the war of 1971, when Pakistan took the help of US to save it against the war with India. At that time, India took the help of USSR. So we can say India had this option to take it could balance the power and could take the help of US also and USSR, as India was not a member of US or USSR. So it could balance the power of superpower against each other, as India had signed a friendship treaty with USSR for 20 years. Along with it, at that particular time period, India also had good relations with US. So that is why India's policy of non-alignment was criticized and said to be unprincipled and inconsistent. India's, as a member of non-alignment, its policy was said to be unprincipled. Unprincipled, why it was said unprincipled? Because many of the members said that India was not following what NAM is meant for. The meaning of NAM was said to be not to be a member of any of the superpower, US and USSR. NAM was a separate organization which was not a part of any two alliances. But here India was maintaining good relations with USSR also, and with good relations at the time with US also. So its policy of non-alignment as a member was said to be unprincipled and inconsistent at various period of time. And in the next part, I will be giving you the topics on the questions and some definitions regarding this particular chapter. As I have finished almost all the topics of this chapter, I shall be giving you some questions in the next part. So I think you shall be able to do that easily. Thank you so much.